So an example of convection would be you put a pot of water on the burner and it starts to heat up and starts to boil. So the cool and the hot water start to move around circulating, which forms an example of convection. Okay, an example of conduction would be you have the burner on and you put the pot of water on. And you can notice that the burner, as it turns on, is transferring the heat from the burner to the pot. And as you can hopefully see, because of that, there's now steam coming off the water because the heat is transferring from the burner to the pot. And that's an example of conduction. So an example of radiation would be, let's say you need to boil some water, like she wants some boiled eggs. Well, first you're going to turn on the burner, and then once you start turning on, just notice it starts to heat up, and the heat starts rising off the burner, and you can feel it even when your hand's like this high. The heat is coming off the burner and up to your hand. That is an example of radiation. Okay. So now we're going to do an example problem of Q equals MC delta T. Now let's go over what each symbol means first. So our Q is our joules heat, so let's go ahead and mark that. Our M is our mass, and our mass is 5 grams. Okay. And now our C is specific heat, and our specific heat is going to be our water cool. And it's going to be 4.18 because the specific heat of water is always 4.18. And then lastly, we're going to move on to our delta T, which is the change in temperature, and that's going to be our 75 to 25. And we'll worry about subtracting those later right now, but let's just first read the problem to see what we're looking for. So how many joules of heat are given off when 5 grams of water cool from 75 degrees Celsius to 25 degrees Celsius? So as you can see here, we're going to be looking for our Q. So let's work this out. First, let's get rid of our delta T and figure out what the temperature will be. So we are given 75 degrees. And then we're going to be taking 25 degrees from that, which is going to equal out to be 50 degrees. And after you do that, it ends up just being a simple multiplication problem. So you're just going to replace your M with 5.0 grams. And then you're going to replace your C with 4.18. And then lastly, you're going to put your 50 in here. You're going to multiply them. And don't let the symbols mess you up. Don't think about the degrees Celsius or the grams. Just think of them as regular numbers this time. So when you multiply 5 times 4.18 times 50, you get 1,045, which will be your joules of heat. All right, thank you. So for this example is a heating curve graph, and I'll be using the example of an ice cube over the temperature and time. So the ice cube will start off as a solid, and the solid will start to be heated. And once the solid is completely melted, it will maintain that temperature for a little bit, and then once its temperature will start to boil, the temperature will keep on going up until it's completely boiling, and as the same as the solid, it will maintain that temperature. And once the liquid becomes heated more, it'll slowly become a gas, and the gas will start to heat. And that is an example of a heated curve graph. All right, so let's go into an example of endothermic heat, or endothermic. So let's say it was a hot, sunny day and you want some ice cream. Well, you go to get some ice cream and you notice that it starts to melt. Well, this is an example of endothermic because when you start to eat the ice cream, the cold starts to absorb the heat will make the ice cream start to melt. Now this is also another example of thermal equilibrium. It starts to melt because it tries to equalize the temperatures of cold and hot. And that is an example of endothermic. Alright, so an example of exothermic would be, let's say you were going camping with friends, you're all sitting around the fire, you're like, man, I want some s'mores. Who doesn't want some s'mores? So you pull out the marshmallows and you put the marshmallow over the fire, and you start to notice that it starts to brown. Well, this is an example of exothermic because the heat from the fire tries to transfer onto the marshmallow, which makes it start to burn and turn brown because the heat is transferred from the fire to the marshmallow.